Welcome to 10th standard biology class. This is the biology lesson, our environment. Our environment means everything that surrounds us. It means surrounding us. In our environment, there are two components. One is biotic, another one is abiotic. Biotic means living things. Abiotic means non-living things. Biotic example, plants, animals, microorganisms. Abiotic means non-living things, example, soil, water, air, atmosphere. These biotic and abiotic components constitute ecosystem, means interaction between biotic and abiotic component form ecosystem. In ecosystem, there are two types. One is natural ecosystem, another one is artificial ecosystem. Natural means God-gift. Artificial means man-made. Example for natural ecosystem, river, sea, lake, forest, mountains or ocean. Artificial means man-made. Agricultural land, arid field, dam, garden, aquarium. In ecosystem, living components depends on one another for their survival. Means each organism feed on the another organism. It constitutes the food chain. Food chain interaction constitutes the food web in the nature. In ecosystem, depending upon the one organism to another organism, forms a food chain. In food chains, producers, consumers, decomposers are there. Producers means plants. Plants means autotrophs. You know that one? Autotrophs prepare their food itself by the sunlight and nitrogen and all the soil minerals by the photosynthesis. That's why producers form the first step of the trophic level. Consumers. Consumers means animals, microorganisms. That's why they are called heterotrophs. Hetero means dependent on the others. That's why these heterotrophs constitute herbivorous, carnivorous, omnivorous, parasites. Herbivorous means feeding on the plants, sasyahari, second step. Carnivorous means feeding on the meat. These are the third step. Omnivorous means top level of the carnivorous. They eat both plants and flesh. Parasites means they live on the another cells. And decomposers. Decomposers means microorganisms which feed on the waste and dead body. For example, if you put a vegetable peels or fruit peels in the any one of the mud, they will decomposers feed on them, they will become a good manure. That's why same way dead bodies also. That's why decomposers belongs to the fourth step. This is the food chain. Example for food chain. Food chain means it is a sequence of energy transfer from one organism to the another organism. Example, grass. Grass is the T1. T1 means trophic level. Producers, grasshopper, herbivorous, T2, trophic level 2. Frog, carnivorous, trophic level 3. And snake, secondary trophic level or a carnivorous, T4. Eagle, top carnivorous, T5. What is this T1, T2, T3, T4, T5? These are the trophic levels. Then what are trophic levels? Trophic levels are the various steps in the food chain. See here the pyramid of the trophic food chain. Plants. Plants belongs to base of the pyramid because they are numerous in number. That's why they form the basic level. They are called T1. Trophic level of the food chain is called the plants. Producer. Herbivorous. Means which are feeding on the plants constitute the second trophic level. Carnivorous, which feed on the herbivorous, they form the secondary consumers, means T3. Next, carnivorous and top carnivorous, which are feeding on the carnivorous. For example, tiger feed on D like that. Tertiary consumers. That's why T1, T2, T3, T4, they are the steps of the food chain. And food web. The interconnection between the food chain forms a network. Is called as the food web, like your network connection. Is how it connected to the overall world. In the same way, it food web is going to be formed. Next, flow of energy. You know that one, by the food chain, energy is going to flow. The food chain is a unidirectional. For example, sun energy got by plant, plant energy got by herbivorous, herbivorous got by carnivorous, carnivorous got by top carnivorous. But it will not go in for the reverse. For example, the sun energy, if feed go to the plant, but plant cannot give back to sun energy to the sun. Same way, herbivorous cannot give back to energy to the plants, it will flow to the carnivorous. That's why flow of energy is a unidirectional. And green plants capture only 1% of the sunlight for their photosynthesis process. And 10% law. What is this 10% law? The energy got by one organism to the another organism, only 10% of the energy is flowing from one step to the another step. For example, 90% of the energy is going for their metabolic activities. Metabolic activities means maybe digestion, respiration, excretion, all the other parts of the work. And what is 10% law? Plants. Plants are the first step. If they have 2000 kilojoule of energy, when plants are eaten by deer, they only 10% of energy passes through the deer. Means 2000 joule converted into 200 joule. When deer is eaten by tiger, again 10% of energy passes to deer to tiger. Means 200 joule to 20 joule. Like this, energy is going from one step to the another step is a very low. That's why food chain contains maximum 3 to 4 trophic levels only. Next, biological magnification. What is biological magnification? When we are going to have a food, along through the food and water, some of the chemicals are entered into our body. That's why the chemical concentration, harmful chemicals enter our body and increase of chemicals, it due to concentration is going to be high. That is called biological magnification. You know that one, chemical is not a biodegradable. Biodegradable means which feed on microorganism that is going to be decomposed. Non-biodegradable means it is not going to be decomposed by the microorganism. That's why harmful chemicals are stay on going from one organism to another organism. Highly biomagnified animal or organism is the last food chain. Example in this food chain, T5, which is eagle. Eagle is the highly biomagnified. In human is the highly biomagnified animal because he is the top carnivorous. He is eating all and belongs to omnivorous. That's why. And ozone. Ozone is when oxygen decomposes, O2 converted into O plus O. That single O is again belongs to O2 and form O2 plus O, O3. O3 is the chemical form of ozone. That's why ozone important work is it shields the ultraviolet rays, harmful rays from the sun and protect the living organisms. Deflection of ozone leads to skin cancer, cataract. That's why we have to use less of CFC. CFC means chlorofluorocarbon. We have to be less use of fridge, less use of AC, and CFC free refrigerator we have to be used. So we have to be prevent ozone depletion by human activities. That's why world universe is celebrating September 16th is the ozone day. That's why we are all belongs to eco-friendly nature. This is your lesson, our environment. This lesson regarding worksheets are provided by the school, you have to solve in your notebooks. Thank you. Welcome to chemistry class. This is a chemistry lesson, chemical reactions and equations. In our daily life, many of the chemical reactions are going along with us. For example, digestion, respiration, and milk become curd, and painting, and rusting of the iron. And these are all the examples for chemical reactions. And in laboratory, we can go for how the chemical reaction is happened, which are the changes we are going to be found. Change in the color. When chemical reaction is happen, there will be a changes in the color. For example, paper burning. Take a paper, burn it. When it paper burn, it become an ash. Paper of the color is also going to be changed and state. The paper state is solid. Now it's become ash, but solid state. And liquid. Liquid transmission and temperature is going to be changes when chemical reaction happen. When for example iron mingle with the sulfuric acid, it form an iron sulfate, and along with that it forms a temperature is going to be released. When you touch a test tube, it become a hot. That's why change in color, change in state, change in temperature represent the chemical reaction is happened. And formation of a chemical equation. Representation of the chemical reaction is called as a chemical equation. The simple way to write a chemical reaction is called an equation. For example, magnesium react with oxygen forms a magnesium oxide. This can be written as Mg plus O2 to MgO. This is in the formula of the elements. Mg is the formula of magnesium, O is the formula of oxygen, and MgO is the formula of magnesium oxide. And chemical reactions, there are two types. One is balanced, another one is unbalanced. Balanced means both the reactants and products having the equal amounts of elements. So chemical reaction, when they are having equal number of atoms of products and reactants, is called as the balanced chemical equation. If it is not balanced, it means unbalanced reaction. Unbalanced reaction is also called as the skeletal equation. One more question, what is skeletal equation? Unbalanced chemical equation is called as the skeletal equation. And what law is going to be follow the balanced chemical equation? Follow the law of conservation of mass. What is meant by conservation of mass? Mass neither be created nor be destroyed. It should be one form of mass is converted into another form of mass. For example, mass of the reactant should equal to the mass of the product. That's why conservation of mass law is going to be followed. And number of atoms remains the same in the balanced chemical equation. And types of chemical equation. Come to types of chemical equation. One is exothermic. Exo means out. What is out? Thermic means, thermal means heat. When heat is released, it is called as exothermic reaction. When water is poured into a calcium oxide, for example, sunna, nothing new. When you are going to mix calcium oxide with the water, it releases calcium hydroxide and enormous of heat is going to be released. That is called exothermic. And endothermic. Endo means enter. Thermic means heat. Heat is going to be absorbed. It is called as endothermic. For example, to break any compound, it required a heat. That's why endothermic. And in endothermic, there are three types. One is photolytic, electrolytic, and thermolytic. Photolytic means breakdown of the compound by the sunlight. Thermolysis means breakdown of the compound by heat. And electrolysis means breakdown of the compound by electricity. So there are three types under the decomposition reaction. And what is combination reaction? Combination itself telling combine. Two or more reactants combined to form a single product is called as the combination reaction. And decomposition reaction. Taken as the single reactant, breakdown into two or more products is called as the decomposition. And displacement reaction. More reactive element displaces the less reactive element from the compound. For example, iron is the displaces copper from the copper sulfate solution and form the ferrous sulfide and the copper. and double displacement. Exchange of ions between the compounds is called as the double displacement reaction. It also forms the insoluble substance called precipitate. It is also called as precipitate reaction. Example, barium chloride when combined with the sodium sulfate, it forms the barium sulfate and aqueous solution of sodium chloride. And another type of reactions are there. One is oxidation, another one is reduction. Oxidation itself, addition of oxygen. For example, copper combined with oxygen to form a copper oxide. Okay, and removal of copper oxide, 2CuO when combined with the hydrogen, it forms the H2O plus copper. Means here removal of oxygen is called the reduction. Here copper is oxidized, here copper is reduced. And in due to a chemical reaction, some effects are going to be happen. What are those? Due to oxidation and reduction, corrosion and rancidity is going to be taken place. What is corrosion? Corrosion means metal get oxidized, corrode. Okay, means how we can going to be prevent? There are two components. One is air and moisture. When metal come to contact to air and moisture, it forms a corrode. For example, rusted iron. How to be prevent the corrosion? One is P. P means painting. O means oiling. G means greasing. Another G means galvanizing. Another means alloying. Painting, metals should be painted. Time to time we have to make a ironing, greasing, galvanizing means, for example, it is a metal. Another zinc coating we have to make like a overall metal. Then this overall layer protect the metal. That is called as galvanizing. Alloying means mixing of one or two metals or a non-metals to form a another new substance is called as an alloy. For example, brass bell. Next, rancidity. Rancidity means food going to be get oxidized and become a bad smell and it's become spoiled. That is called rancidity. For example, pickle become tasteless and when boost is came on the food. For example, how to be prevent? By the flushing the nitrogen gas. For example, chips pocket, you having some air. That air is the nitrogen. Chips pocket should not be spoiled, means they are flushed with the nitrogen gas. And airtight container. You have to put the food in the airtight container box. Otherwise, you have to use the refrigerator to keep the food. And add antioxidant. For example, for the pickle to lead a long time, your mummy adding salt to that pickle. That lead to antioxidant. So if your food has to be live for long time, means you have to use the antioxidant. So these are the lesson regarding chemical reactions and equations. So solve the worksheets which are provided by the school.